Vielen Dank. I don't speak German, but I can understand some things, and I think you did tell almost everything. I have nothing to say now. Actually, I understand a little bit because I don't speak, but I love Sarah Leander, and you know that Sarah Leander was singing at Raymond Theater, at the theater in Denver, but many, many, many years ago. It's another story. As you did say, the vertical gardens actually at the beginning were not at all to make vertical gardens, but it was to have a biological filter for my aquarium. So you see, at the beginning, I was thinking when I was very young, about 15 years old, thinking about this problem of ecosystem. Well balanced, and I wanted to have aerial plants to have the best way to have elimination of the waste products, especially of course nitrogen, which accumulates in aquariums. So I did use the plants in this for this goal, and finally I did see that the plants were very well growing without soil, simply with the minerals included in the water, and very well growing. So I did put more and more plants above the aquarium, and of course I had to fix the plants, and to fix the plants you need a material, and it's why now it's a little bit interesting for you and for the subject about the problem of reduction, zero energy. Of course we know we have still to wait a little bit more time to be sure that we can have zero energy cities. Depends of course also on the global climate. What you do in Vienna is not the same as what you can do in Monte Carlo, or what you can do in different towns according to the global climate. But actually, to make the vertical garden, you need a support, and of course, this is the interesting part about the problem of insulation from the building, because when I do a vertical garden, I use a metallic frame, and you have a gap, few centimeters thick gap, of course, that you can fill with insulating material. After, you have a panel which can be either expanded PVC, or what is better is fibro cement, and also as an insulating power. Then you have the felt, which is the medium for the roots of the plants, the growing medium for the plants, so which is also with the power of insulation, so it's a third layer. And of course you have the plants also which have power for insulation, both for the sound and of course for temperature. But anyway, even if you read many things about the power of insulation of vertical gardens, there are actually very few really scientific and precise reports about that, and there are still many precise works to do according to the plant species, to the season, to the kind of effect, to the thickness of the material to fix, so for all these different aspects. So there is still much work to do about that, but of course it's it has big insulation, high insulation power, especially because, as I told you, you have four successive layers, and as you know, insulation is always better when you use different types of materials. I show you, so just to explain that my work actually was totally inspired by nature. Of course, at the beginning, it was an experiment with aquariums, but after, as soon as I was 19 years old, I did go for the first time in Malaysia and Thailand to go in the forest to observe, when I was at university already at 19 years old, to observe the plants growing in the shade of tropical rainforest. And after, since that time, I'm always working on the adaptation of the plants to the shade of tropical rainforest. I mean the plants which receive only 1% of the sunlight, which is the canopy of the forest. So I did travel many, many times, and still, because tomorrow I go to Singapore and to Malaysia tomorrow evening, for instance. So I still travel a lot in a forest, and I have always new observation and new inspiration for my vertical gardens, because up to now I did realize about 300 different vertical gardens all over the world, and for each project I have always a new selection of plants, of course according to the global climate and also according to the special situation of the project. For instance, I did finish a work with Jean Nouvel on the Praterstrasse 1 in Vienna. I did visit this morning. It's not the same because it's a protected area, not the same even if it's in Vienna. It's not the same as if it's a wall directly exposed to the wind, etc. So you see, you have always different things to consider to install the plants. Bon. Okay, so you did see some different photos of nature. In this one, the first one, you did see waterfall, and of course around the waterfalls you have always many different species according to the proximity of the water. And it's all these vertical substrates are about biodiversity, very important, because of course as it's vertical, you have many different macro habitats depending on the availability of the water, and depending also on the fact that you can have some humus in pockets. For instance, here you see limestone cliff in southern Thailand. On the case of a limestone cliff, due to erosion, you have many pockets with humus. So in this case, you can have bigger plants than when you have only stones which have no pockets without humus. So you see, in nature, you have different kind of natural vertical gardens according to the type of the rock, the nature of the rock. I work in Austria, in the Wels, for Fronius, in Wels, very recent work, some months ago. In Vienna, Praterstrasse, I did take the photo a few weeks ago. You can see it's not far from here. Another detail of Praterstrasse. It will be officially open on next Monday. A project with Herzog & Demeron for Miami, the Miami Art Museum, and I shall cover about 100 columns you see with plants. A project I did design for a house I like very much. It's for a hotel in Athens. I'm not sure it will be realized, but I like this kind, you see, of an interaction between the plants and the architecture. A project I go in a few weeks in Hong Kong for this project, for a hotel for a university. It's a hotel of the university. And finally, a big work with Jean Nouvel in Sydney on the high rise building, and I shall have many patches. You see, many vertical patches with vertical gardens. It will be in 2 years about. A work I did propose in Dubai, and so it was huge panels. And you see, in this case, I did use only the water issued from air cond, because you have not to forget that through respiration and transpiration, we lose at least 1 liter per person per day. And with the three buildings, the three towers, I could have about 65,000 square meters of plants only using this water, which is always lost, which is incredible in countries like Dubai. There's a waste water of the respiration and transpiration, and it's a perfect water because it's totally pure. So, of course, for all the projects in this kind of countries, first of all, I try, of course, to use water for aircon. I think it was the last image. So maybe you have some questions.
Thank you so much.